It's exciting technology, and we know from our customers that time to charge is a big deal when it comes to further build out of the electric vehicle car park and adoption. But, you know, it's not the only thing. I mean, we see this exciting advancement, but it's going to be a long time to roll out this technology because of a couple things. One of the biggest issues is also around EV adoption itself. And some of the things that hold it back are location of chargers, the speed of the charger, which we're talking about here today, but also the reliability and uptime. And the number of chargers needed is pretty significant. And what this technology really says is that a lot more investment is needed in this infrastructure. And this is a very costly infrastructure to roll out. And with a 1 megawatt charge, which this is asking about, or really saying which is needed, then that says that that whole infrastructure, including the grid, needs to move forward too. So there's a lot of technologies needed to move this forward.
And it's China, where they're willing to put in that investment, Mark, where they're backed by the government, where something different is happening in the U.S. What do you think is the ability of America to keep up with this type of technology, to get something that looks like what BYD is promising in super fast charging networks?
So, you know, you bring up a really valid point because it requires the government to really step forward and make that kind of investment. The infrastructure today for EV charging electric vehicles, you know, it's a small part of all vehicles on the road. And that infrastructure works, but it only works for the early adopters. And as you sort of tip into how do you start attracting the mass market for EV drivers, it really requires a lot of incentives to be able to put that infrastructure in place. And you see that going forward in China. But not only the number of chargers, think about the amount of electricity required. So what BYD is talking about is 1 megawatt per charger. And that's equivalent to about 2 Whole Foods grocery stores in terms of amount of energy required. So there also needs to be a build out on the electrification infrastructure. And then you've got data centers on top of that. So there's a lot of competing demands to be able to advance that EV technology. So we believe that it will advance, but it's not going to advance at the rate of what people have thought.
I mean, are you actually confident that the U.S. electric grid is up to snuff or can be brought up to snuff in the near to medium term?
Well, it can be brought up to snuff, but it requires a lot of investments to get there. And I think, once again, this technology really shows that there are many pieces that need to move forward. You know, another piece, too, is think about the vehicle to be able to accept this kind of charge. You have to operate on a platform that really is in its infancy. There's hardly any vehicles on the road today that would be able to accept this rate of charge. So that's a big investment from automobile manufacturers. So it's multifaceted, where you see many things have to occur to move past this early adopter phase into more mass market in the United States. So we believe it's coming. It will just take time. It's going to take a lot of investment, which is why we also believe that it's going to be a multi-fuel future, and consumers are going to want to look at optionality.
Mark, quick question on the vibes. You're not a Tesla company, but I wonder, have you seen any attacks on your infrastructure? And, you know, I've seen chargers that have been, many chargers, not yours, but others, your competitors, that have been broken for long periods of time, even pre-Tesla backlash. So how are you dealing with that?
You know, what we do is we provide the software and capabilities to make the system a lot more reliable, and we work a lot on uptime, which has been a big problem for the industry. But as we advance our technology, we see folks getting much better at it. So, you know, it's hard to control the public opinion around that. We are, by the way, hardware agnostic. We're also vehicle agnostic. So we're not necessarily subscribed to Tesla, and we don't necessarily fall into some of the traps that Tesla might be falling into. But at the same time, I think it shows that there are a lot of challenges out there to get this infrastructure right. And we also we're one of the world's leaders in providing the petrol-based infrastructure. And if you look at fleet operators, look at compressed natural gas, renewable natural gas, biogas, which Vontier is also positioned there. So I think it's about bringing our customers forward in a very realistic way. While we love EV charging, we're one of the leaders in the world of providing that infrastructure, it's going to be optionality for many decades.
I just wonder, Mark, and this is almost another way to ask Matt's question, is what's bad for Tesla bad for the entirety of the industry? If you start to see a backlash because there is this connection, rightly or wrongly, to Elon Musk and political affiliations, which, let's be honest, he has been very close to President Trump, if we are seeing a backlash to Tesla, does that seep in to the wider industry? Have you seen any impact, or does it remain very idiosyncratic to Elon Musk's company?
You know, I think if you asked that question 5 years ago, I think it would be kind of very different where we're positioned today. I mean, look at the OEMs that are out there advancing their products, very exciting products coming to market. And I think that the car park, as it evolves, you know, it's going to take more than one company to make that evolution. And I think you see that. You see a lot of OEMs, not only U.S., but also in Europe, stepping forward, and clearly folks around the world, it's more positioned where it's not just one company. And any sort of mass market adoption of something like electrification for the car park is going to require the whole ecosystem moving forward. So I don't think that it's up to one company to make this happen. It's up to the many companies to make it happen.